How's it going, everybody? I got a quick tutorial for you. So tonight we're going to be doing pretty much a repeat of a previous video, but a little bit different. So about a month ago, I put out a video on how to move your Plex metadata from your home drive to a separate drive, a different drive. Now you'd want to do this just to clear space on your home drive, and maybe just so to get faster load times with some of this metadata. But let's get into the meat of this. There was a guy who posted a comment on that video asking, how do you do this on Linux? And I thought, you know, what a great question. I should do a video on this. I'm pretty familiar with Linux. I'm not an expert, but I know my way around the terminal and all that stuff. So we're going to jump in here and I'm going to show you how to move your Plex metadata and as well as your transcoder cache if you're interested to a separate drive. And I'm going to be doing this in a Debian-based Linux. Now the process should be the same for any Red Hat or Fedora based distributions as well, but I can't guarantee that, but I'm pretty 99% sure the process is going to be the same. So the first thing you're going to need is a drive to move it to. So I have this little NVMe drive that I have connected via USB. It shows up as a regular drive, but it's plugged in via USB. This is for demonstration. This whole Linux is running on a VM in Hyper-V. So that's why it may appear to be running kind of sluggishly. It is a VM running within my Windows operating system. So first thing you're going to need to do is create a folder for your metadata and your transcoder cache. Now, if you don't really care about moving your transcoder cache, that's fine. So transcoder cache runs out of the temp folder traditionally, which usually runs from RAM storage. But if you're really short on RAM and you want to move the transcoder cache, your transcodes aren't happening fast enough, then you might want to move it to an SSD, but only an SSD. Transcoder, you know, it needs a fast drive to really run properly. So if you're going to move the transcoder cache folder, make sure it's to an SSD. Otherwise, just leave it where it's at. And so we're going to create two folders here on the drive, one called Plex Metadata, one called Plex Transcoder Cache. Now you can call these folders whatever you want. This is what I've chosen to call them. And like I said, if you're not moving the transcoder cache, don't create a folder for the transcoder cache. So once we have those two things created, I'm just going to say right now, you may run into permissions problems when you do this, which I had a problem with. So you may need to go into in here in terminal and set permissions for these two folders. So I would do like user group plus read write execute other minus read or minus write execute and add read, and then I would add Plex, the Plex user, because Plex operates as a user called Plex. I would add Plex user to the root group and make sure that you give ownership of the drive to you as a user, and then make sure that the root group has read, write, execute permissions for that. If that's too complicated for you, I may make a follow-up video on just on how to change permissions and all that stuff, but it would make this video a little bit long and drawn out if I go into how to set permissions for each folder in the hierarchy of that. So hopefully you don't run into that issue. If you do, I'm pretty sure there's only one guy who really wants to know this stuff. So if you do run into that problem where you're having a permissions error, or it says, you know, Plex is having trouble accessing this, whatever, just let me know, put it in a comment. I'll make another video showing you how to change all that stuff. But if you're a Linux user, you're probably pretty familiar with how to change ownership and permissions for a folder or a drive and all that stuff. But yeah, some people may have problem with adding Plex to the root user group, but I don't think it's a big deal. But then again, you know, it's really up to you. It's personal preference. That I add it to the root group just because if the drive ever unmounts itself, let's say it goes into sleep mode and Plex wants to, you know, access that drive, it might not have permissions to remount the drive as just its own user. So you have to add it to a group that has permissions to remount the drive. Root's always going to have permission to do that. So it just simplifies things. Okay, sorry, let's get into it. All right, the first thing you're going to want to do, you can do this one of two ways, really. You can get to it through Terminal, or you can get to it through the GUI. Let's just do it through the GUI right now, just for simplicity, just because going through Terminal is going to be a little bit slower, and it may not be as easy to follow along with. But you can do that through the Terminal. I'm just going to say that right now. So let's go to the root. Let's get to the root directory. Process can be a little bit different based on whatever file explorer you're using, but you're going to get to the root directory. You're going to go to user, lib, Plex media server. Where'd it go? Lib again. And then down at the bottom, there's a file that pretty much gives you instructions on how to move this stuff. It's a little hidden gem here. So there's a little file called plexmediaserver.service. Let's just open this up and let's read it. So it says, do not edit this file directly. Okay. Plex Media Server's variables can be customized by creating an override.configuration file using system control edit Plex Media Server, which will create the following. And it shows you where this configuration file is going to be stored. And then it shows you here how to exactly what to enter to change the locations of your temp directory, which is the transcoder cache, and the Plex Media Server application support directory, which is the metadata. So let's go ahead and get into the down and dirty. Come on down, take a ride. Got something for you. Come on, you're gonna like it. Okay, that's enough of that. So let's go ahead and sudo system control edit Plex Media Server. Oopsie. So let's go ahead and jump into getting this configuration file written. So let's go ahead and take a note from what they said to do. We're just going to get some of this stuff a little bit more neater in here. Okay. Okay, I'm going to go over here to Plex metadata, and at the bottom here, you can see this is our absolute file path down here, and you'll only want to include one slash in front of media, not three like it has down there, so just remember that. So let's type this in. Environment equals quote tmp dir equals. Now I've already copied and pasted or copied the absolute file path because I'm a slow typer and I like to copy and paste. Haters gonna hate. Okay, and this is the temp directory, which means it's the transcoder cache directory. So like I said, if you're not moving your transcoder cache, skip the TMP DIR and skip to the Plex Media Server application support directory location. That's my fault. All right, and then we're going to type in Plex transcoder cache. It's my like Bane light voice. I know you like it. It's okay. You can use it. All right. And then we're going to go in again. Environment equals quote Plex Media Server support. Wait, Plex Media Server. Oopsie. Forgot to add application. Support dir equals, once again, the absolute file path, but remember to change the folder on this one from the Plex transcoder cache. We're going to call this Plex metadata. Very nice. And now there's options to change user and group, but don't do that in this, in the configuration file. It's better to, if you want to change the group for Plex, to do that in the terminal as with a super user functionality, not in the configuration file. So now we got this done. Now we get this done. Go ahead and hit Control O to write it out. And then Control X. And we're going to go to, we're going to type in sudo system control restart Plex Media Server. Boom. Now let's just confirm that we got this dialed in. So we're going to copy this because I'm a copy and paster, like I said, and we're going to go sudo nano paste. Boom. Yep. It's there, baby. All right. And then we're just going to go ahead and exit because we didn't change anything. All right. That's the gist of it. That's how you change that stuff. Like I said, if you have any problems getting permissions set for that external drive, let me know. Leave it in the comments below. I'll make another video explaining exactly how to set user group permissions and ownership for the drive and the folders within to make sure that Plex can access those folders. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you like this video. Appreciate all the views and more to come. Another video coming out next week. I got a killer PC build coming your way. It's the overkill build. It's the thick daddy build. It's the thick boy build. You guys will know what I'm talking about next week. I know that sounds kind of strange, but I got a Leon Lee 011 Dynamic. I got a RTX 3090 MSI Gaming X Trio Edition, and I've got an Intel 10900K, an Asus ROG Maximus 12 Extreme Extended ATX motherboard. Oh, it's so sweet. Oh, it's so juicy. So juicy. Juicy. Okay. But it's pretty much my overkill build. It's pretty much my dream build. I'll go into more detail in the next video on why I did not end up going AMD, why I did not throw in, you know, a Crosshair Extreme and a 5950X, and my decision why I didn't go AMD, or I actually did go AMD and I had to come back. It's kind of a messed up story, if you ask me.
Kind of messed up, man. Traumatic, man.
But it's overkill build. I've been doing some case mods on this Leon Leo 11 Dynamic just to make everything fit. I got two Fatboy 360 mil radiators in here. It's the titties. Okay. All right. Thanks again, guys, for watching. I appreciate it. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later.